never been till you put me down. Oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now, blew me too.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good morning.
Evening already?
Yes.
Not yet.
Yeah, not yet. Say hi
some
more. Say hi. Okay, so today.
So, today what we're gonna learn?
HRC.
Good. And what company that we're gonna
focus on? Hotel. And Grand Continental Hotel.
Good. Students, good.
Alright. So, do you guys know what we're gonna have today? Games.
Yes.
Who like games?
Me.
Do you like games?
Yay,
okay.
Yay.
So you know what's the better? The catch is that I'm going to test you guys and maybe ask some questions, and you guys have to provide a good commentary on based on what questions I'm going to ask.
Oh.
All right. Based on this one. Yay.
Oh.
All right. And whoever can provide a very good reason, I have something
chocolate
for you. Yay,
wow.
Chocolate. Yay. Okay. Okay, so you guys know what we're gonna do, right? It's about this one. Yay, what is this?
Ratio analysis.
Ratio analysis, and can you read for me?
Current ratio.
Yay! And anybody knows how to count this?
Me.
Okay, Sabaria.
Current asset over current liabilities.
Good, give round of applause.
Yay!
Okay, guys, so now let's start. By looking at this current ratio between Shang-Ri Hotel and Grand Continental Hotel. So are you guys ready?
Yes, yes.
Let's hit it. Yes. As per shown, is the current ratio for the year of 2012, 2013 and 2014 for Shang-Ri La
and
GCE. Yay! Okay, so as you can see, Sabaria, can you tell me how's the Shang-Ri La's doing when it comes to the current ratio?
Based on the ratio analysis made for Shang-Ri La Hotels and Resort and GCE, it shows that for their liquidity ratios, for current ratios, GCE did better than Shang-Ri La. GCE's current ratios were increasing with excellent numbers from 2012 to 2014, which means they were in standard liquid position to cover the firm's current liabilities by cash and inventories. In the meanwhile, Shang-Ri La was having a huge trouble with consistent current ratios below 1 from year 2012 to 2014, and this shows that they are disabled to pay off their short-term debt.
Good job!
Yay.
Yay! And you know what you got?
Chocolate!
One chocolate for you.
Thank you!
Because you've done your research well. Okay, so next, what we're going to take a look on is the quick ratio. Alright? For the same company. So, Sohana, could you do me a favor and explain a little bit about what you have found?
For the asset test ratio for GCE, the ratio was with better than Shang-Ri La. GCE was in a good liquid position to cover the firm's current liabilities by cash, while Shang-Ri La was unable to pay for their short-term debt. They were not in a good liquid position to cover short-term debt. Nevertheless, they might able to increase their liquidity ratio if they reduce current liabilities by liquidity inventories.
Okay guys, so basically, which one is the best when it comes to the quick ratio?
GCE!
Good! Okay, so I'm just gonna put it here. To GCE, 0 for Shang-Ri La.
Yay.
So, good one, Suhana. One chocolate for you.
Yay. Congratulations.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so next one, what we're gonna do It's about inventory turnover. Yes. So Yen, can you please tell me about this a little bit? What you have done?
Answer this question. Okay, for the asset management ratio, inventory turnover, both Shangri-La and GCE had a good asset management along these 3 years because both of them had frequent stocking, restocking, in the last 2 months. Even so, Shangri-La had a more favorable asset management because it did restock more frequent than GCE, which show that they were more efficient in generating revenues, especially during 2013.
Okay, so basically, which one is the best?
Shangri-La!
Yay, one for Shangri-La here. Yay. So, one chocolate for Yen!
Yay! Yay.
Here you go. And now I'm out of chocolate.
Wow.
So, yay! So, moving on to the next one would be
debt ratio.
Yes. Can anybody tell me what's the formula for debt ratio?
Yen.
Yes.
Total debt over.
Over.
Total asset.
Yay! Remember. Okay, so now let me chat on this one. Okay. So basically, alright everybody, so I'm going to explain to you about debt ratio for the year of 2012, 2013 and 14, alright, for both companies. And as you can see, for the debt management ratio, both companies' performance was doing quite well, as none as ever exceeded 33% for the debt ratio. Alright, so however, the measurement for Shangri-La short and long-term debt has been increasing yearly. Okay, in addition, Shangri-La debt has been continuously higher than GCE for 3 years, and the debt was undoubtedly could be worsened, which signifies the opportunities for securing additional borrowed debts and limited. Next one, I'm going to compile everything, not everything, okay, three ratio at one time, okay?
Account receivable.
Yes, account receivable turnover. And the next one is what?
Time interest earned.
And the other one?
Assets.
Yes, these three. So let's start with Suhana. Three ratio at one time, okay?
Account receivable.
Yes, account receivable turnover. And the next one is what?
Time interest earned.
And
return on assets.
Yes, this. So the next three would be on return on equity, net profit margin, and average collection period. So let's start.
Shangri-La.
And return on total assets.
GCE.
No.
Yes, why do you say no?
I disagree. Both companies were inconsistent in generating profit from their assets. So
you believe that it's no?
Are not doing good.
Okay, so how about you? Yeah. We couldn't agree more?
I couldn't agree less.
Okay, so I'm just going to put dash. Cross here.
Yay.
Start with Suhana.
Besides for the efficiency in the collective receivable, Shangri-La was doing better than GCE. This means that Shangri-La was more efficient in the collecting their receivable, even though GCE took took slightly longer time than Shangri-La. in collecting their receivable. Both companies were still efficient in collecting their receivable.
Return on equity. Okay, as you can see here, what can you conclude out of it, Suhana?
Alright, for the return on equity, GCE showing decreasing value from 2012 until 2013, but increase in year 2014 with highest numbers. For every 1 ringgit invested by common shareholders, GCE managed to generate 5 cents of income for the year 2012. 0.13 cents for the year 2013 and 3 ringgit and 12 cents for the year 2014. While for Shang-Ri, for every 1 ringgit invested by common shareholder, Shang-Ri managed to generate 9 cents of income in year 2012, 13 cents of income for the year 2013 and 8 cents of income for the year 2014. Even both companies were inconsistent in generating incomes. For the return of common shareholders, both companies were not making any loss from there.
Okay, so basically on return on equity, what do you guys say about this?
Both company
not good. So I'm gonna put cross here.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, for the average collection period, which one is better?
Shang-Ri.
Yay. Okay, so we have come to a conclusion. Conclude this. Alright, when it comes to which one is better for us to invest on, why is it both of it that you do not want to invest? Is that because
So looking at the profitability ratio, that is net profit margin, for every 1 ringgit of sales, Shang-Ri managed to get 22 cents of net profit for the year 2012, 33 cents of net profit for the year 2013 and 23 cents on net profit for the year 2014. Meanwhile, for GCE, for every 1 ringgit of sales, GCE managed to get 37 cents of net profit for the year 2012, 13 cents for net profit for the year 2013 and only 2 cents for the year 2014. So judging the company by looking at the net profit generated, Shang-Ri was doing better at GCE as they were showing increasing consistent profit yearly compared to GCE, which were having decreasing numbers of profit yearly.
Okay, let's go. Alright, when it comes to which one is better for us to invest on, why is it both of it that you do not want to invest? Is that because both of the company is inconsistent when it comes to their performance, and it is very risky. It's high risk. Okay, even though they're making profit, but it's a small profit. Yes. Okay. When I say small, it's very small. Okay. Okay. So when it comes to the conclusion, do you choose Shang-Ri or do you choose Grand Continental Hotel for you to invest?
None of both.
May I know why?
Because
what?
It brings loss to investors.
Yes.
Both of the company not making any profit. Okay. For conclusion, I can get for the current ratio, it's best to the GCE company. For the current ratio, also for the GCE company. And then we go to the inventory turnover, which is Shang-Ri Hotel, hold more. Then moving on to the ratio, GCE is more better. Account receivable turnover, back to the Shang-Ri, back to the end, also Shang-Ri hold it. Return on asset is not good enough for both of the companies, and also for the return on equity, not good for both of the company. And for the net profit margin, goes to Shang-Ri. Lastly,
average collecting period
goes to
Shang-Ri.
Aku punya. Bloopers. That's it for today.